Hey everyone, I'm Manuela with Plytix. In this video, I'll show you how to use and save filters in the product overview so that you only see the products relevant in the moment. Filters in Plytix are basically our answer to 1, the lack of team collaboration in spreadsheets, and 2, having to manage and update different spreadsheets or tabs for different sets of data. One of the main benefits of adopting a PIM system is that all of your data is centralized, reducing the amount of duplicate data that you have around. But we get it. Sometimes you don't want to or need to see all of your data. Filters are great for this because they let you segment your products into smaller groups so that you can see and manage data for a specific set of products without having to create an entirely new spreadsheet for it. So let's take a look at how we work with filters in Plytix. When you're in the product overview table, you should see the filters menu on the left-hand side of the page. If you don't see it and instead only see the table like this, then you probably have it hidden, in which case just click on the Show Filters button here. There are 3 elements to the filters menu. Up here, you can choose which product family you want to see and work with. If you want to learn more about product families, check out the video that I'm linking here. Next, we have the section where you can save and load filters, which I'll explain more about at the end of this video, so stay tuned. And finally, you'll see the filters options. You can filter your products by any attribute or relationship that lives in your Plytix account. First, I'll explain how to filter by attributes, which if you don't know what attributes are or how to create them in Plytix, then make sure you check out our video that I'm also linking here. And after that, I'll explain how to filter by relationships, which is a bit different, so you might want to stick around for that. All right, let's look at the attributes filters. Say you only want to see products of a certain supplier. Just filter for that custom attribute. Ours is called supplier. As you can see, there are different options for filtering. These options can differ depending on the attribute type that you're filtering on. In this case, we're filtering a drop-down attribute. So you can choose is defined to see all the products who have the attribute supplier filled in, is undefined to see the ones who don't, which is a great option to see which products you should be filling that information in for. You can choose is equal or not equal to search for or exclude a specific supplier, and contains or doesn't contain any of if you want to see or exclude multiple options. If you want to see all the filters that are available for each attribute type, the Help Center article that explains that is linked in the description of this video, so make sure you check that out. All right, so let's say we only want to look at the products supplied by Printful. Just apply the filter supplier is equal to and select Printful. Now we've narrowed down the products we see to 211, but let's say we want to narrow this down even more. See how below your filter you can select either and or? This allows you to choose another attribute to filter by so that products have to fulfill both criteria to appear in the results or at least one of the criteria depending on the operator that you choose. So let's say we only want to see the products supplied by Printful that aren't ready to be uploaded to Shopify. For this, we'll use the and option so that we only see products that match both of the selected filters, and we'll include the filter for the completeness attribute Shopify ready is not equal to 100. And now we've narrowed it down to 44 products. Pretty great, huh? If you want to learn more about completeness attributes, you can check out the video that I'm also linking here where we explain all about them. Okay, now let's say we want to see the products that meet the criteria we've just set, but we also want to see products that meet a second set of criteria. So for example, if we want to see both the products supplied by Printful that aren't ready for Shopify and also products that are ready for Shopify but don't have the supplier attribute filled in. For this, we'll keep the current filters and add the or option to add the second group of products that we just mentioned. So Shopify ready is equal to 100 and supplier isn't defined. Now we have 104 products. If you want to edit any of the filters, you can click into the filter, make changes, and hit apply filter. So here I'm going to change the supplier that we're looking at. Instead of Printful, I want to see the suppliers from Teapop. Now let's look at filtering on relationships. The first thing you need to know about filtering on relationships is that when you add a relationship filter to attribute filters, relationship filters work as an and condition, meaning if a product meets the attribute criteria you set and meets the relationship criteria you set, then it'll show up. The second important thing to note is that you can only filter by one relationship at a time. All right, so when filtering for relationships, you click the plus button here to add a filter, then select the relationship that you want to filter for from the dropdown. And by now you already know this, but if you want to learn more about creating product relationships in Plytix, then check out the video or our help center where we explain how to do that. Once you select the relationship, you'll notice some more options will appear. Here you can set the criteria for the filter. So is defined or is not defined. And you'll notice that if you choose is defined, you'll also see the option all SKUs selected. You can just leave it like that, or if you want to filter some specific products by the quantity of relationships that they have, then you can click on it to narrow this down. But this is a little bit more advanced, so I won't go into it in this video. Oh, and before we move on to saving and loading our saved filters, I forgot to mention a super cool thing about using filters in Plytix. I mean, I think it's cool. Maybe you won't think it's cool, but I think you'll think it's cool. Filters in Plytix work on a user base, which means that while we're here filtering for these specific products, someone else on the team can be filtering at the same time for an entirely different set of criteria, and this won't affect what we're seeing, which means easier collaboration, which, if you remember, is the first point I made at the beginning of this video. And you can even use these filters together with table views to basically recreate having another tab or another spreadsheet without having to go through the trouble of, well, keeping that updated. And where were we? All right, saving filters. So you can save these filters that you've just created, which is great if you want to view the same group of products later on, if you want to share them with a colleague, or create a product list based on the set filters, all of which is way better than having to save different sets of products in different tabs of sheets, right? So to do that, click on the floppy disk icon at the top of the filters menu to save your filters. Here you'll see the option to update an existing list or create a new list. For this example, we're gonna create a new list and I'm gonna call it Shopify To Do and click Save. If instead you wanted to just modify a smart list that you have already created, then you'd select Update Existing List and choose the list that you wanna update from the dropdown here. Now, just to show you how this works, we're going to eliminate our filters by clicking on the little trash can that appears when you hover over the filter. And to load the filter we just saved, click on the folder icon here and choose which list you want from the dropdown. Once you click load, you'll see the filter criteria that we set up in the last step and the products that correspond to that criteria. To see how you can use filters to create both smart lists that update automatically or static lists, check out our next video. I hope you found this video tutorial helpful. If you have any questions at all, feel free to reach out to your customer success manager or talk with a member of the Plytix team by using the chat on our website. And of course, if this video was helpful, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more product information management tips and tricks.